Hello, welcome at Tech Talk episode 10. Also in this episode, I will try to answer as many questions as possible that you left on our YouTube channel. The first question is coming from Jimmy, and he asked this 4 months ago, and the question was, I'm trying to save electricity cost when connected to the shore power. Well, coincidentally, Jimmy, we just launched a solar and wind priority feature. This means that you can upload a feature in your firmware of your multi and also on your servo if you have one. And what it does then is it prioritizes your wind and solar over your shore connection. That means the shore connection is still there, but it's not active. Only when your batteries are, well, almost empty or there's too less energy from the wind and sun, then the shore power kicks in. But all the other charging is done by wind or by solar. So this is surely helping you a lot in saving cost on the electricity bills. The next question is coming from Bartley May, and he is asking, why is it so that the systems within Victron are limited to 180 kVA when you're using 15 kVA Quattros? What happens if you use more? Well, theoretically you could use more, but the problem is then the DC currents and also finding the correct fuses and finding the correct main switches becomes much more complicated. So therefore we have limited to 180 kVA. So theoretically it could be possible, but in practical, well, you shouldn't do it because you run into too much engineering issues. Another question is coming from Ivo. And Ivo is asking, can I operate an MPPT and a MultiPlus without a battery? Well, Ivo, you cannot, because an inverter needs a stable power from the battery. An MPPT is sort of a battery charger from solar, but this will not be enough to supply all the energy what an inverter is needed for peak loads and for these kind of circumstances. So if you want to run these, you have to have a battery connected, and otherwise the system will fail or not even start up. Another question is from John, and John is asking, is it okay to mount a Victron inverter charger sideways because of limited space, so in this direction? Well, John, that's not an issue at all, because there's active cooling in an inverter charger, and actually also in the charger itself or in the inverter itself. That means that the orientation itself doesn't matter. The air will also be blown through the electronics to provide a proper cooling. So the way you mount the inverter is not relevant at all. Another question, and I hear that actually quite a lot, is that if it's possible to use a diode in a heating element of a boiler or a coffee machine to reduce its power, so that you have a, let's say, a 1300 watt coffee machine and you make it a 700 watt. Well, inverters don't like that, because the current shape will also change then, and it makes a lot of noise in the inverter, but also the inverter has a hard time measuring the exact power and producing the right sine wave. So I'm sorry, but you cannot do that. If you have a coffee machine drawing 1300 watt or even more, you also need an inverter which is capable of doing that. And things to avoid that, well, I'm sorry, but not possible. The last question is coming from Mulan. And Mulan is asking, I have an EasySolar-II GX and also the lithium smart batteries combined with the VE.Bus BMS. Do I need to install also the mains detector? Well, Mulan, you haven't, because the mains detector is only for the first generation of multis and quattros. So if you have an EasySolar-II or a MultiPlus-II or a Quattro-II, you don't need the mains detector, because that feature is already built in that unit itself. That feature is there to switch off the unit completely when the battery is in idle. So to save idle power from the inverter, the whole inverter is being switched off if the battery is also empty. Well, the two models, so the MultiPlus-II, etc., they already have that built in. So then there's no need to install the mains detector besides this. Thank you for watching this episode of Tech Talk. If you have any questions about our products, leave them in the comments bar below.